Hey guys, through here with Narevit for Blender. This one we're going to be talking about breaking shading upon export into Texturing Engine. So let's say that you have a mesh, right? And, you know, let's say you want to export it to a Texturing Engine and everything's fine, shading looks great. Let's take this piece, for example. There are no problems at all, right? But when you export to a game engine, texturing engine, we got some problem in here, by the way, we're gonna fix that. You know, things start breaking and you're thinking like, what the hell is going on, right? Now the reason is very simple. Texturing engine is going to triangulate your mesh, so it's gonna do something, you know, like this to it. Okay, so if I go to edit mode, go to face mode, select everything with A and press Ctrl T to triangulate, you're gonna see that things gonna start breaking apart, and that's what's gonna happen to your mesh. So now the way to battle this, right, is that you need to clean this before you export it. Now it depends what you're exporting, because if you're exporting, for example, just a low poly, that's fine. But if you're exporting, you know, a low poly and a high poly because you want to bake some high poly maps, you're probably gonna have to triangulate both. And this one is a, you know, example of a high poly mesh, right? It's a really old rifle I made some time ago. I don't really like it much anymore, but you know, it was ages ago. But anyway, it's a good example because there's a lot of cuts and bills and whatnot. So anyway, let me show you how I would probably go about, you know, fixing something like this, because you see that it's a bloody mess. And the reason why you know, you got these shading problems is because now these edges are conflicting with the bevel that goes around. So if I'm going to apply the bevel right here, all right, you will see, you know, what's causing the problems, right? So let's go back in time. Now let's go to bevel and press Z, and you can see that in live mode what's happening to this edge. Let me zoom closer, right? So, and again, bevel and Z, and you can see how this bevel is actually messing up the whole shadings, because these edges here, you see these edges that fall into the bevel, the angle is simply too steep, and it's causing the bevel to break, right? So now the way to detriangulate is, the best way would be to use hard ups. We can just simply place clean mesh and everything is peachy. So now the way I would tackle this, right, like for example this corner I'm just going to show you on this example here, right? First of all, I would need to fix the edge flow. So I would probably, you know, fix these two edges here. I would remove this junk in here, because I don't know why do I have double edges here. So probably what I would do is just combine them both, right, like this. I would recalculate the whole mesh, because I got some sharp edges here. So shift control click on sharp, and which should remove them, but for some reason didn't. And let me just see my settings here. Let me just apply everything. There you go, one more time. Sharp and boom, there you go. And I'm going to remove these because they're not necessary, right? And I'm going to connect this one properly as well. So select these verts, shift one, select this, select these two verts, shift one, combine these two, J, and remove this edge. Okay, so this is a proper edge flow now. Now, in addition to this one, this is not enough, right? We need to create kind of like a support for these arches. So if I was, you know, if I was doing this properly, I would probably have to, don't worry about this left one. We only going to be worrying about the middle part. Okay. So, right. So I would probably have to run some kind of an edge here, right? Like this. Okay. Press E and continue on the other side. Right. So something like this. Remember, it's a high poly, so you don't give a shit about poly count, right? All it matters is just a clean shading. So you could try doing something like this, and you could either, you know, correct them one by one. I go to hard ops and use the Mesh Machine Star Connect, okay, which is a great tool of Mesh Machine, which will connect all these verts into one point. Then you've got still these left, so we're gonna have to triangulate them probably manually. This is a little bit steep, so I might actually create another subdivision here and bring this point to the left. So with machine tools, select these two and, you know, star connect, right? So this will probably give me a good, you know, good triangulation here, and help me to make this corner, you know, maintain the shading. Now we need to have a hard edge here, because I think that's an angle, right? So we need to mark it, and everything is peachy. So now if I'm going to triangulate this, right? Watch this corner and this corner, what's gonna happen, right? So you see the shading on this corner now is perfect, right? You cannot see any pulls whatsoever, but on places where we didn't fix it, there's a good possibility that things gonna start falling apart. Anyway, guys, this is just a quick tip on triangulation and how to, you know, how to make sure that you prepare your mesh for exports. But if you want to learn more in depth on the subject, consider getting our game asset course, which we released yesterday. There is an early bird period, 20% off until end of Sunday. So, you know, if you want to get it, grab it now. 20% off, links in the video description. You can get it on Gumroad, Blender Market, and blenderbros.com. Now, we enabled streaming on Gumroad, so you can download or stream on Gumroad. And we enabled downloads from our website, blenderbros.com, so you can stream or download from our website. So we just gave you, you know, a bit more choices, right? Because some people wanted to, you know, watch it offline or when they commute or whatever. So we decided to add these options. So I think it should be possible to do it now. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed the vid. Give us a like and sub if you did. Links to all the add-ons that I'm using, like Hardups, Boxer, etc., in the video description. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.